You may have already heard about the most common strategies when it comes to prompting, such as be specific, provide examples, set the context. In this video, I'm gonna give you more concrete strategies that give you a clear idea about what to do and how to use ChatGPT or any other large language model more efficiently. And it's gonna be a lot of information, so grab a cup of coffee and let's go. A lot of the things I'm gonna show you today will be in the form of templates. So let's actually start with understanding how writing templates is actually a prompt technique. And why does this work? Well, if you learn to create prompts in the form of templates, it will make you focus on building more structured prompts. Plus, it will save you time in the long term because once you've crafted about 10 good templates, you can obviously reuse them. Another point is that writing in a structured format forces you to think in a structured format. And when you think in that structured format, you write better prompts. So let's give you examples. Write a marketing campaign outline that uses blah to persuade blah to take action and purchase blah. For every section in the campaign, give step-by-step instructions. In general, asking ChatGPT or any other large language model to think in terms of step-by-step gives you better results. And this is something that you may have heard as a framework called chain of thoughts. It doesn't need to be so complicated. Just ask the model to provide reasoning and concrete steps for whatever it's doing. Second template, I want you to act as an expert in topic. You have all the information about anything to do with this topic. In general, actually, I recommend you repeating the most important parts of your prompt. Like here, you may think that the first and the second sentence are kind of repetitive, but they're not for the large language model. And you can see already here from the response by ChatGPT that it understood clearly what we want from it. And now we're ready to go. Let's say now that you are a researcher and you want to create a template that helps you with your research topics. Generate a table with 5 concise, for example, research question options that incorporate relevant academic keywords for a paper focusing on whatever topic. And let me actually show you the output here. It is so good what ChatGPT did that I really wished I had this when I was doing my PhD. And I don't know the future, but whoever is doing their PhD right now, they are lucky. Might be difficult in the future to get a PhD with all this AI development. I'm not sure how things will work out, but right now, right here, good stuff. And I can imagine that you're getting a little bit tired here and your attention is fading away. So let me show you a puppy, because who doesn't like puppies? Second technique, flipped interaction. Every time you're not sure about the topic or how to ask your questions, use the flipped interaction technique. Let me show you. Example number 1, I would like you to ask me questions to help me diagnose a problem with my internet. Ask me questions until you have enough information to identify the 2 most likely causes. Ask me 1 question at a time. Ask me the first question. You can reframe this a bit and say, I would like you to ask me questions to help me create variations of my marketing materials. You should ask questions until you have sufficient information about my current draft message, audience, and goals. Ask me the first question. Or you can actually ask ChatGPT to be the one creating the prompts. From now on, whenever I ask a question, suggest a better version of the question and ask me if I would like to use it instead. We're actually going to build upon this technique in the next technique called critical or being critical. In general, a way to improve your prompts or the responses you receive from ChatGPT is to ask it itself to be critical. Let me show you a couple of examples for that. If there are alternative ways to word a prompt that I give you, list the best alternate wordings. Compare the pros and cons of each wording. In general, asking a model to compare the pros and cons is motivating the model to be more critical of its output, which makes the output better. You can also make sure that your prompts are understood correctly by the large language model by saying, for anything that I ask you to write, determine the underlying problem that I'm trying to solve and how I'm trying to solve it. List at least 1 alternative approach to solve the problem and compare, or you can say contrast, the approach with the original approach implied by my request to you. Another scenario is when you ask ChatGPT for ideas and it gives you very generic responses. Let's say you asked for YouTube video titles. I want you to act as a critic. Criticize these titles and the reason why they are bad. Let's think step by step. Or let's say you asked for business ideas and it gave you a list, but you want to have the best ideas out of this list. Out of the X titles, which one would you choose? Rewrite, let's say, 5 variants and convince me why these are better. Finally, to max out the critic approach, you can say, act as a harsh critic and provide brutally honest feedback about this, let's say, email titles. Convince me why they're bad. And maybe it's time for second attention check, so look at this puppy this time. I promise, I have a video of a cat as well. It's coming up. Use markdown or actually any other type of XML tag. For example, you can say, write the key points of a lecture on cognitive psychology using markdown. And what you'll see here is a very good outline that follows the markdown technique. You don't see the actual hashtags here, but you don't need that. In case you do want to see the hashtags, you can actually ask ChatGPT to provide you with the code for markdown. Now I'm going to show you how to use the HTML tags, and this is just another way to, one, help you think through what you're asking and how you'd like to see it formatted, which could result in more accurate and helpful responses from the model. I'm going to use a template tailored for software engineers, and you can see it covers the different kinds of technical queries they may have, and it also allows for customization in terms of programming languages, frameworks, and coding style preferences. Basically, this is combining the idea of having a template and using those tags to format your input and output better. Trust me, when you start using ChatGPT more frequently and you have such information, the time you're saving by having it so visually organized, it will start to make a difference very quickly. I did say I have a cat video as well, so here we go. Next technique, Professor Synapse. Alright, so I heard about this prompt from another content creator and I'll show you so that you know about it, but it's a bit complex and I'll recommend you read through it. I'm gonna leave the link to the GitHub repo so you can actually go and see the documentation as well. But basically what happens here is that you're giving instructions that not only give some rules for the current prompt, but for the entire communication. Some people even use that prompt as custom prompt, you know, in ChatGPT-4. Now you can customize your profile. So I'm gonna show you this in another video if you don't know what I'm talking about. But my point is that this prompt could be your base prompt for any conversation. Let me just show you real quick. If I say start, it's gonna tell me what it is, what it's doing. And then it's gonna start prompting me to provide it information so that it can help me. What would you like to focus on today? Well, let's actually create clear prompts for ChatGPT. So here it's gonna start by asking you more questions to understand you better. And let's say we're gonna say education to help developers. It's going to confirm that it understands my query, and then we're gonna continue with yes. See here how it kind of changed its dominion. So you didn't have to tell it play a role. The prompt already knew that it's supposed to be doing that, which means the responses will be more tailored to that role. And then it tells you how it's gonna help you. It's gonna tell you the steps that it will take. Here, if you don't like some of the steps, you can obviously change it. But the main point is not for you to know the steps as much as for the model to know what it's doing and to follow a structure. In a way, you have to think less by using that prompt. You just have to say your sentence and then the prompt itself improves everything for you. Let's say we want to help developers who want to improve their code. I think this is the most common reason why developers go on ChatGPT. Again, it gives you the steps. And at the end, it asks you if you'd like to start with this list or should it give you some suggestions. Maybe we can start or actually give me some suggestions. Okay, so here we have some good lists. And actually, if you are creating content for developers, you can use that list to those are good 10 titles for a video if that's the niche of your YouTube channel. If you actually have a YouTube channel, whatever, back to the prompts. So let's say I say, yes, give me a prompt for the first question. Again, it's just doing the whole thinking for you. And it's gonna finally generate the prompt that aims to help developers improve that question we asked about debugging skills. And then it's going to ask you if you want to refine this prompt or if we should proceed to create prompts for the other categories. All right, next technique is the power of adjectives. I'm going to show you a few different techniques how to improve your content style or in general writing style. Whether you have to write a script for a video or you want to write a book or presentation or email, here are some techniques that will help you. So how can you be more persuasive? Say this to ChatGPT. Rewrite my text with powerful, convincing language that will leave my readers no choice but to take action. Or how to make your text sound more informative. Rewrite my text with rich, informative details that will leave my readers feeling educated and informed. Or more humorous. Rewrite my text with clever, comedic touches that will leave my readers laughing and entertained. Or more action-oriented. Rewrite my text with urgent, action-oriented language that will inspire my readers to take immediate action. Or more empathetic. Rewrite my text with emphasis on the emotions and feelings of the characters or subjects I'm writing about, making the reader feel and connect with the story more. Finally, let's say you want to be more concise. Say, rewrite my text using more concise and to-the-point language, making it more direct and easy to understand for my readers. I think you're ready for another attention check video, and let's put two pets on the screen. Actually, does a mouse count as a pet? Well, I guess it depends on whether you feed it intentionally or not. Ah well, let's go back to our prompts, frameworks. And we're not going to talk about chain of thoughts because at this point, I think everybody has heard about it. So I'm going to show you something else that maybe it's also simple, but it can really help. And I haven't seen that much content about it. So tree of thoughts allows the large language model to have superior reasoning and ability to rectify errors and acquire more knowledge or perform deliberate decision making. And the prompt I'm going to show you first, it's actually very good if you are preparing for negotiations, debates, any more complex topic or situation. You're going to have the keywords, which are note, thought, backtracking, and answer. And feel free to pause the video here so you can read through that. And then I'm going to show you the prompt. Again, pause the video because I don't want the video to be 1 hour long, but I'd like to show you the result of this prompt and you'll see what's happening. So the question was how long it's going to take you to dry 7 pairs of socks based on this experience with the 10 pairs. And by the way, I took this prompt from Deep Learning. They really have a lot of nice courses. Again, I recommend them. But back here, you can see how expert one will say, well, if it took 10 hours for 10 pairs, then for 7 pairs, it's going to take 7 hours. Then expert B is going to correct this and expert C is going to critically evaluate and agree with expert B. You may not see the immediate benefit from this, especially if you haven't asked ChatGPT to do math questions for you. But if you are trying to solve any more reasoning or logical solutions, mathematical equations, whatever, this prompt can help you because from being correct 98% of the time, like 5 months ago or something, now ChatGPT is correct only 2% of the time, which is a long story why, but it actually is still very capable of performing. You just have to prompt it a bit better or differently. You can also ask ChatGPT to think in terms of tree of thoughts. So let me show you this now. Imagine that you're a senior software engineer at a large tech company. You are leading a team of developers who are building a new social media platform. What are the key technical challenges that you need to address? Answer using the technique tree of thoughts. ChatGPT knows that technique, so you don't have to explain it to you. You just have to clarify that you would like it to use it. And if you do so, you're gonna see how it first lists different challenges, and then for each challenge it gives sub-challenge. And I would say this is really good both for your personal use if you want to prepare, but also if you're preparing a presentation or have to outline a plan or KPIs. It's just really very useful technique. I hope you see its potential as well. And now before you go, I want to give you one last piece of advice. The most important part of the prompt should be in the beginning and in the end of the prompt. That is not correct for every single large language model, but it's currently correct for ChatGPT. Also, whenever possible, we should avoid context stuffing. Research shows that context stuffing can quickly degrade the performance of large language models. And I'm gonna leave the link to this article in the description box so that you can check it out yourself. But basically the point is that if you use too many tokens within a single prompt, it's not a great idea. And also the location of the most important information and instructions is relevant to the efficiency of the prompt. So I hope this video helped you guys. And actually, I'm gonna leave the link to my prompt library as well. It's a bit messy, but I update it frequently and maybe it's gonna help you. Also from there, you can copy paste a lot of the prompts I just showed you in this video. So thumbs up if this video helped you, and I'm gonna see you in the next video. Bye bye.